Hello everyone, this is Sabihuddin Ahmed Siddiqui and thanks for watching Computer Science O-Level Component 0478 and 2210 Pre-Release Material 2016 Paper 2 Problem Solving and Programming. We have expected questions answer sessions published by Pre-Release Material Cambridge International Examination. Now take a look at the question set. First of all, we have to go through the pre-release material and understand what the student has to do. Now first of all, we have a question answer sessions based on this pre-release material. You can see that these instructions first, read these instructions first. A candidate should use this material in preparation for the examination. Candidate should attempt the practical programming tasks using their chosen high-level procedural programming language. Now as far as the procedural programming language, basically a student must have mastered before, or if he she has a programming skills or they have developed some programming skills, they can use any high level language such as basic C, Java, C++, PHP, any web based language. So in any of the languages he she can demonstrate their skills. Now coming on to the point, which is the description given by CIE. Now take a look at that. Now this is divided into three tasks: task 1, task 2 and task 3. First of all, we have to take a look at task 1. Now what they ask from the candidate, that means the manager of the building material delivery service needs a program to check the contents and weight. First of all, to check the contents and weight, you can see that I am just highlighting the particular wording so that the student can understand easily what he she has to do. To check the contents and weight, that means you can see the weight is given here in the pre-release, and the contents which you will have to set for achieving the required orders being placed. To check the contents and weight, that means you have to set the conditions first where you will read the content of sacks to ensure that correct orders are made up for delivery. That means what number of sacks was ordered and what was the weight of each sack and something like that has to be tracked using program controls. Now next is that a piece for the order will be calculated. That means a price of the for the order will be calculated. That means the student will focus on these two sentences first, that he or she has to track for the contents and its weight. Now come to the next line, write and test a program for the manager. That means what the student is required to do and to demonstrate his skills. That means your program must include appropriate prompts. Means that the student should give the input entry for the entry of data. Now for the entry of data means that a student must include the input statement so that the content and the weight must be input and validated. Now you can see in the next sentence, that is error messages. Error messages means, for example, if the weight is higher than the required weight, must be prompted that the weight is higher than the required weight. And other output, means if related to the, that means if other diversion is required, that means if the weight is there, that it has to confirm that you do you want this weight or other weight, so that can be directed easily. Need to be set out clearly, that means the clear meanings of the instructions should control the program. Next is all variables. All variables, such as, for example, you declare some variables for cement, for its price, for its weight, for its overall weight, and calculations, different calculations will involve the overall programming functions. Constants, basically you will be creating some constant to validate whether this price is greater than or lesser than those constants you have created and declared in your program. Now, and other identifiers. Other identifiers basically means here you will have to find the data type, such as, let's suppose if you have to declare the data type you are using to hold the value in integer variable, that means you are going to calculate total number of bags. So the type of bags must be integer. That how many bags, let's suppose 20 bags, 30 bags, 40 bags, how many. So this will identify the type, that which data type associated with this type of operation, that means inputting total number of bags, which should be integer. Then you again declares, if you want to store the weight, definitely the type of weight must be fractional, that means it must have, it must contain decimal point. That means the data type must be identified as decimal. That means decimal will store decimal or float or double, which will identify that you can store the decimal values while taking weight. Let's suppose 24.9 and 25.1. So this is the type of decimal variable. So now on the other hand, let's suppose if you are going to store contents. So content type is defined basically in character data type. That means character means only one. And on the other hand, if you are going to make a combination of letters or characters which will be pronounced as a string, that means more than one character means strings. So if you have strings, if you are going to take a string input, you will be initializing with a string keyword. If you are going to initialize character, so you will be initializing with the word keyword character, let's suppose character content. So this will be identified this way. And then if you have an integer input, if you have a double input, if you have a decimal and real and float, so you will be identifying according to the type or according to the calculation requires, let's suppose decimal fractions and something like that. So now moving on to the next, you will need to complete these three tasks. Each task must be fully tested. Must be fully tested means there shouldn't be any way out that the instruction goes empty or the user has input data which is not tested. So now when you provide the input prompt, so the user will input some data. On the basis of data, you have a check at the in the background that you are just catching the input from the user and then you are testing and validating which type of data he or she has entered. Now considering task 1, check the contents and weight of a single sack. Check the content and sack weight of a single sack. That means the contents. Content means this is the content. C is for cement, G is for gravel, and S is for sand. Now you can see each sack must obey the following rules to be accepted. Now here what the examiner requires, contains cement, that means C contains cement, that means C will act like a switch, that means you have turned the C on, that means it will call the cement procedure. When you turn the G on, it will bring the gravel procedure. When you turn the S on, it will show you the sand information that you will be manipulating with all these three different operations one by one. And on the occurrence of each, that whenever C is pressed, G is pressed and S is pressed, what will happen, that the program will provide you with the screen in which you are inputting your desired data for cement, for gravel and for sand with different options required by task 1, task 2 and task 3 respectively. Now coming on to the second part, sand or gravel must weigh over 49.9 and under 50.1 kilograms. Now here in this line, you can see that here one thing which I must clarify here, with a letter on the side for easy identification. Letter on a side for easy identification means that letter on a side, this is the letter on a side for identification of cement, for identification of gravel and for the identification of sand. So now in this way you can see that the letter, single letter which will be acting as a switch, or when you turn this on, cement will call. When you turn G on, gravel will call. Again, I am just telling this you so that you can keep this in mind. And as for sand, so now coming on to the second part, sand or gravel must weigh over 49.9 and under 50.1 kilograms. For example, if you declare a variable, because both the things have the same weight, 49.9 is the least weight and 50.1 is the max weight. So now let's suppose if you want to store 49.9, so you must validate this thing at the time of weight entry. Now as the weight is entered, if the weight is lesser than 49.9 and greater than 50.1, then there must be a prompt or alert that will identify, or that will prompt you to makes you understand that there is something going wrong. That means the weight is not within the range. So this should be the valid message or invalid message will be associated with the correct entry or wrong entry. Now, on the, as far as the wrong entry is concerned, definitely the weight must be re-input and the counter should be there to count how many rejections are there and how many acceptances are there. Now, so this will count the counter and this will also check that how many rejected with the counter and how many accepted with the counter. Each time whenever the weight goes higher than the required amount of weight, then there would be a counter which will calculate separately how many rejections are made and how many acceptance or accepted weights are there. So now on the third one, that is cement must weigh over 24.9 and under 25.1 kilograms. So that means if the weight again similar to this, the second one, that you have to again check the contents and the weight of the, let's suppose especially for cement which is fixed with 24.9 weight and 25.1 kilograms bags. Now here what the user has to do, the student has to check which kind of weight is that and how to check this. You have to use if constraint. So whenever the value is input to the variable associated with cement, gravel and sand. So you can even keep one variable, combined variable for sand and gravel, and if you want to keep separate variables for sand, gravel and cement, so it's up to you. So now you can declare them separately or you can just combine one variable for two things which have the same weights, and for cement you can just have the one separate variable for holding 24.9 kilograms and for 25.1 kilograms. Now you have to set the condition, let's suppose you have to set the condition, and then when this condition meets the requirement, so the other procedure will be called. Let's suppose if the weight is equals to this, then the input total number of bags should come. And basically this is totally logical, this is basically based on your true logic. That means you are handling by your own. Let's suppose you have been given a task and you are handling then and there. So you have to take decisions logically, you don't have to assume something, you have to assume things in a way realistically. That means the thing should be realistic, that okay, if I am having this problem, what to control and how to control this thing. So this approach should be developed, and then you have to drive the same concepts for tracking other inputs and validation checks. Now input and store the weight and contents for 1 sec. Now here they are asking you to input and store the weight and contents for 1 sec. That means what was input and what was the weight of this. So store weight, that means if you have a store weight constant, if you have created a constant for weight, minimum weight and maximum weight, and if you have to enter content, let's suppose if you press C, so C will highlight that which kind of storage or which kind of input is going to be asked for 1 sec, let's suppose 1. So in this way you have to divide your instructions and to get the weight and contents and to separate them one by one. Now the content must be checked and must be checked, contents must be checked. That means you have checked them, whether C is pressed, whether G is pressed, whether S is pressed, and what was the weight for cement, what was the weight for sand, what was the weight for gravel. And now you can see an incorrect message or incorrect sack rejected. As I have told you before, that if the weight greater than the required amount of weight must be rejected, and every time whenever the weight goes higher or lesser, the counter should count total number of entries when the weight was higher and when the weight was lesser. When the weight was equal, then you have to again count that how many correct orders were placed, right? So now the weight must be validated. Again, I am clarifying this thing. Let's suppose if over and higher weights, you can count that how many times lesser weight and how many times greater weight. You can count separate variables, right? And for the correct orders, you can count another separate variable to track total number of correct orders. Now, this next sentence is the weight must be validated. Now here, you are just going to validate the information or the entries of weight and contents on entry, and right on entry, And now you can see again they are asking you to just an overweight or underweight sec rejected, as I have just told you to declare two different variables to verify whether the weight was higher or lesser than that. So now here you have just seen that how to track all those contents here in this pre-release task 1. So this will be kept in mind while writing the pseudocode. So now coming on to this, output the contents and weight of an accepted sec. Now here you have to calculate it, whatever was detected and whatever was traced during the input of the contents, and to calculate the weight and other things which was already discussed. So now output the contents, that means you are just showing that what was entered as content and what was the weight of an accepted sec. That means it was, if the weight was 24.9 for cement and 25.1, then definitely the weight will be displayed, that this weight was entered and this was the weight and this was the content. If a sec is rejected, output the reason. And again, I have already explained this thing, if a sec is rejected, then you are going to output the reason why. Definitely, simply, if the weight is not meeting the requirement, that means lesser than 24.1 or greater than 25.1 or lesser than 49.9 and greater than 50.1. So in all these conditions, if they are meeting the requirement, definitely all the entries, all the checks you have put in the program or pseudocode will validate the program entry and calculations and value with the values, that how many types of values have been calculated and tested. So on each validation you will have your logical reasoning, and then you can check all the inputs in double way. Let's suppose if you check this, let's suppose if whether the content is C, or let's suppose if you can see if the weight is, if minimum weight is greater than 24.9 and weight is less than 25.1, you can just combine this two condition in one conditional statement. That is, if weight, input weight greater than 24.9 and weight less than, or C weight less than 25.1, so you can compose a condition based on two conditions. You can compose in one condition, that's like that, that you can just write the collective statement of two conditions and tracking in one condition. So now this is the way you have to deal with your pre-release material, and I hope you will like this. So thanks for watching.